Hello, YouTubers. Welcome back to another episode of Dark Souls Remastered Guided Playthrough for the PS4. Today's episode, we're going to finish up Ulysil DLC area and maybe do a little bit of running around to finish up some questing before we do the finale, okay? So, first off, we just finished up fighting Knight Artorias in our last video, so we're going to try something here. There's an item we need to get out of this area, so I'm going here, and that's the item you want, that purple power crystal. Read that real quick. Online play item, quick battle of stoicism. Session ends and post leaves. Victory in this battle once led to ancient Anilondo, but even in the absence of its overseer, capitulation is a disgrace, in the name of a warrior's honor. Do not quickly resort to use of this crystal. Basically, you can just quit when you're doing a PvP match. That's PvP right in there. So, next what we want to do is go to the Ulysil Sanctuary and talk to Elizabeth. Have a word or two of dialogue for us for defeating Artorias.
Thank goodness thou art safe. As I wish, I offer thee my all. Thou art from a time far, far ahead. There are many things I wish to ask, but I know that I must not. The perils of our time are overwhelming enough. Was thine eye glancing hither? Thou needst not hide thy wonder. I am a mushroom, after all.
Okay, well, I guess you don't want to talk to us about Artorias just yet. That's all right. We need to go back and talk to Chester. He's the NPC guy over here, the sinister looking NPC guy.
Yes, magnificently so. Believe it or not, Ulysil has brought the abyss upon itself, fooled by that toothy serpent. They upturned the grave of primeval man and incited his ornery wrath. What could they have been thinking? Ah, to you and I, it's all ancient history. You have to ask yourself, does it really matter?
Alright, that
so long.
Exhausts his dialogue for that point of the game right there, so. I can't remember if there's something over here. I don't think so. Maybe it's just empty space. Yeah, empty space. Alright, so we're going to head into Ulysil Township. Make sure you have a few arrows available. You're going to need them. Let's see what we got. 41. Probably going to have to go buy some more arrows, I think. Oh yeah, go up here. I want to show you this one other place at the top of these stairs. Locked door, but there's a really cool NPC up there that we need to talk to. But we have to get the key first. So we're gonna go find the key during our Ludacil Township visit here. So let's get started with that. Alright, so we're gonna go on down into this area. There are two different types of monsters. There's one called Bloatheads, and then there's the Bloathead Sorcerers. The Bloathead Sorcerers are extremely dangerous, and you gotta be very careful when you fight them, because they like to cast this magic, dark spell. I think it's called Dark Orb, but it does lots of damage if it hits you, so be extremely careful against those. These Bloatheads are a good source of large Titanite Sharks, by the way. If you build up your humanity and item find, these guys drop a lot of large Titanite Sharks if you need them. You guys are funny, man. They laugh at you and stuff. There's the shortcut elevator. Takes us down to the abyss where you fight the boss. Sorcerer. There's lots of damage, so you gotta be careful. One second, so gotta look at something real quick. So, trying to find out why Marvelous Chester hasn't invaded us yet. He's supposed to invade you somewhere in here. Maybe it's down a little further, but Chester's that NPC that we just talked to a little bit ago. Oh, here he comes. Yeah. Here you go. There's Marvelous Chester. There, he invaded us there, and we beat him, so. Alright. Time to proceed. There's a crystal lizard down here that is kind of a pain because he runs off the side. It's hard to. Kind of hard to get him. I think he's right here. I think a crystal lizard is on top of that little building right there. There we go. Yeah, we got him. Cool. Yeah. He can be a real pain because he likes to, just run off the side and you can't get to him, so. Anyways, go back up here. This is a mimic. If you hit it from behind, then you'll be able to get a better position on him for second and third hits, so. It isn't the last mimic in the game, but. Very good carving. Let's look at that. Head carved of arch trees by Goff in his imprisonment. Goff imparts an emotion to each and every completed carving, which helps him achieve personal enlightenment. When a head is disturbed, it speaks, reflecting the emotion conferred to it. This head says, "Very good, have another look." Does it not appear quite jovial? Alright, so we'll equip this and I'll show you what it does. So.
Very good.
Yeah, so you can throw it and it talks.
Very good.
Yeah, so there you go. There's the talking heads. I told you earlier, there's that door that has this locked up outside of the boss fight in Notorious. The door leads to Goff. He's up there in that little area, so we need to free him, or at least open the door. He doesn't really go anywhere, but just, yeah, open the door and we'll be able to talk to him and buy some stuff from him, so. Alright, on this one here, you read the message, it says, "Let there be light." That's a developer message trying to tell you that you need to open this pathway. If you use the Skull Lantern to work your way through the Tomb of Giants, that's what it's talking about. So you need the Skull Lantern, and it'll open those pathways. Has a chest in here, yeah. Silver pendant. I think it's an item you use. Let's see. There it is, yeah. Silver pendant engraved with the crest of Artorias, one of the ancient treasures of Anor Londo, presented to Artorias for facing the abyss. Effectively deflects the dark of the abyss, especially in its magic forms. So, you can use this one to help you deflect those dark spells that those blowhead sorcerers, like, shoot at you. Let's see. I'll show you what it looks like when you use it. So you can deflect it and use this like that. We'll try to use it on the bloatheads here, because there's a couple of them that are down here in Garden Treasure, and they are really hard. So, like, without, they're hard to, we call it, beat without without dying to them. Back over here, and then you can drop down if you want right here. Actually might help a little bit because of the there's a pathway inside where our treasure chest is going to be right there, but there's also this bloathead sorcerer here we can kill. And he drops a I'm sorry carving, and right inside this door is where the other ones are, so right there. There's two of them standing right there. So, and there's a chest over there. So, what you want to do is just run in here and try to avoid them if you can. They only take one hit to kill. So, if you can get one down quickly, then that's great. If you can't, then you're probably going to die. So, just run in here, do the best you can. I usually die to those guys. They're a tough duo, let me tell you. So, Dark Orb, that's what they're shooting at us. So that's our new magic for Ulysseal. I guess the opposite of miracles, but nah, it's a pyromancy, I think. Yeah. Abyss sorcery discovered by an Ulysseal sorcerer. On the brink of madness, fire giant dark orb. In contrast to standard soul sorceries, abyss sorceries are weighty and inflict physical damage. Perhaps human souls, because of their humanity, produce sorceries with more tangible presence. Yeah, this just leads to nothing, so. Not the way we came in. Also leads to nothing, so. Let's follow the path back up here. And then. Right here. Well, no. We go this way. Oh, wait a minute, that was the right way. Anyways. Come over here and just drop down. And then make the jump right here. Like so. And then right here. Now there's gonna be a bloathead to the right here. And you can range that sorcerer from over here. Let's do that real quick. Arrange them because you don't have to deal with them running across that narrow bridge. I'm gonna bloodhead behind this. Take him out, and then you're free to walk across the path here without getting damaged. So easy enough. I think that guy hits me almost every time I come in here. So. I just have terrible luck with him. Now there's blowheads in the ceiling right here that'll drop down on you. I think there's like two or three of them. So just walk in this room and just walk around and get them to aggro and then kill them real quick. I guess we just won. Oh well. Alright, so there's two sorcerers and several bloatheads on the floor here, and then there's the one sorcerer up in the top that is easy to kill. And we're gonna try to shoot this guy. Complete disaster. Yeah, we're gonna leave that alone. I don't want to run out of arrows, so. Let's try to pull one of these. Pull them out of. Two at a time or something. So annoying. What you want to do is you want to try to kill this guy on top if you can, so he won't range you. You can shoot him. I think I'm just in the wrong area here. There you go. And make a quick turn here to kill these two guys. Should get you out of danger for the most part. One more blowhead over here still. There we go. Alright, this is the way to proceed forward to the next area. But we have a few things we need to do here first before we go that way, so. That and then we'll we need to knock this thing down too and do it with arrows. Dark fog, our next spell we got. Abyss sorcery discovered by an Ulusil sorcerer on the brink of madness. Create a cloud of dark fog. Although dark fog is, in theory, relatively close to humanity, it also happens to be a terrible poison for humans. Perhaps it reflects man's cruelty against his own. Alright, so going forward we got to go to the left here. Should be another bloathead here. And he hit me through the wall. Use my tactic. How about that? Alright, there's a chest over there. What you do is the same deal like you did before. Use the sculling. Let you in there. Red titanite chunk. Alright, so right here, what you want to do is roll off of this into that little inlet right there. That bloathead is. That's the only way to get in here. So just roll it like so. Take him out. This is the guy we tried to shoot the first thing in here. Did not have any luck with it. And there's another one there. So. Alright, this is a final mimic of the game right here. I got that on, that's why. Yeah, that's not good. Alright, crest key. This is the key to Goff's little area. The grooves of the crest are enchanted. The door sealed with a powerful spell. So that's our way to get to Goff. This is where that sorcerer was. Maybe not. No, I think he was down this way. Oh, wait a minute. That way. Definitely don't want to go that way. So, right here. This is where that sorcerer was that we shot from below. Walking back and forth right here. So. But we don't, there's nothing else down there, so just go this way. Nope, not that way. Go this way. And drop down one level. And then come over here and grab this. Twin Humanities. Down another level, and then another level, and that's the exploration part of that area. So now we're gonna get a shortcut right here. There's gonna be a bloathead that comes down the elevator, so you want to get him out of the way as quick as possible. We're probably gonna go to the bonfire as well to get some more health. We need to buy some more arrows because we're running low. So this is remember I showed you that shortcut earlier? This is where it takes you, so right at the beginning up here. Warp to Andre real quick and grab some arrows.
Anything.
might as well grab the stuff too. We don't have yet. We don't have this sword. And we don't have this. Or this. Or that. There. We don't have a standard arrow. Might as well get one of those. Now we got arrows. Cool. Alright. Alright, let's head back to Uzasil Township. Alright, enemies are gonna be respawned in here, so. Which is fine. No big deal. Okay. So now that we're down here, we got to deal with, I think, see the three bloatheads and two sorcerers. But you see the sorcerers right there towards the end of the ramp. You can shoot them from a range attack and kill them. So if you can, try to shoot them in the head, because it does a lot more damage if you can shoot them in the head. I'm having some terrible luck with shooting here. Alright, so that's it. That's all the sorcerers. Thank goodness. Those guys really suck. Bloatheads, and then we got an item right here. Brave Warrior Soul. Alright, in here there's a one-of-a-kind enemy. It's like a chained, I don't know what you call it, but he's not incredibly hard, but he drops chain like items, like chain body, chain legs and hands and all that. If you need to, if for some reason your undead merchant is dead, like in undead birth, then this guy will drop the chain armor. Chainmail leggings of thin interlinking rings of steel. It is common throughout the human world since it can be easily produced. It is not too heavy and offers good defense. Knights may favor flashy armor, but for warriors in the battlefield, anything is fine as long as it keeps them alive. we're gonna get on over to our last bonfire down here in the abyss. Switch our helmets to our sunlight maggot and give yourself another 2 humanities. Should have enough already with this twin one. Don't worry about humanities, you're gonna have plenty of opportunity to farm some of your benefit still. I think there's also a crystal lizard right up here. Yeah, there he is. Alright. So, on this one, what you want to do is there's a bloathead sorcerer and 3 regular bloatheads over here. If you can pull them individually and bring them to you, that's probably for the best. Because these guys, that sorcerer, really kick your butt if you try to take him and these other ones on at the same time. So all you want to do is just, like I said, try to pull them individually. And then once they're dead, you can go get the sorcerer and take them out. Look how much damage that did. Oh my gosh, I almost died. Dark bead. Let's see what we got. Dark bead. So, in contrast to standard soul sorceries, abyss sorceries are weighty and inflict physical damage, perhaps to human souls, but okay, so that's just pretty much what the other one said. On. Now these guys here, all of them are, they all drop humanities. So you can kill them relatively easy, but they will drain your life if they hit you, so you gotta be careful. We'll go to those guys here in a minute though, I need to do something else first. So. Alright, what you wanna do is go to the left right here. Got a false floor, it's gonna fall off from underneath you. And then you're gonna see Alvina, the cat from the Forest Dwellers. She's trying to take you somewhere, so just follow her. And I'll show you what that means. I mean, these guys. Oh my gosh, just hit him hard. Jeez. She's trying to lead us in here. I can find it. There it is. Yeah, she wants us to help Sif. So Sif is over here, protected, right over there in that shield. All you have to do is touch it and you'll save Sif. There you go. So if you do this area before you go kill Sif in the other place, then he'll recognize you. But yeah, we didn't do that, so he didn't recognize us, but you still have to fight him. We got that shield. Cleansing Great Shield. The steel Great Shield used by Knight Artorias, who succumbed to the Abyss. Artorias, deeply scarred by the Abyss, used this to form a barrier to protect his compatriot Sif. Although this drained the shield, its magic defense remains high. So this one, or actually now that we saved Sif, he can help us in the boss fight of the area. So. And now we're going to get our final shortcut. This is right near the beginning of the area. Right near where Marvel's Chester is.
Is it that you need? Well, you've quite the nerve. I've had enough of you.
Obviously he doesn't like us too much, so yeah. Anyways, that he only says that because he invaded us and we killed him, so he's mad at us now. Back down we go. There is a little offshoot over here on the side that you want to go to where the prism stone is. And we'll go up first. There's a bloathead sorcerer up here. That's why I went this way, because if we don't kill this guy from right here, then he's gonna range us when we're down in the bottom, dealing with all those humanity guys. So. There's another bunch of humanity guys here too. Just take them on one at a time, or two at a time. And one more. Black Flame. A pyromancy discovered from the dark of the abyss by a pyromancer who wandered into Uasil. Conjure a great black flame into one's palm. Black flames are weighty and inflict physical damage enough to smack away the mightiest of shields.
Cool.
Alright. Got the black flame. Cool. Yep. Now that we're done with that area, we go back up here. And there is a few more items to get, and then we'll be ready for the boss fight. The humanity just dropping left and right off these guys. Alright. There's an item to get right here, but just be careful because you can fall to your death and you don't want to do that. I think last time I tried to get that, I died, so I don't know why, but I just did. This is the way to proceed forward once you have all the items. Come down the ramp, turn around, there's one right here. Some more humanities. And then we have the boss fog down there. There's a couple of humanity ghost or whatever right here to take out. Yay, our white Titanite slab. Now we can level up one of our divine weapons, either the occult or the other one. And that is the exploration, all the items for Uasil. So I want to show you guys something here too that you probably know already if you played this game, but if you didn't play this game yet, there's something you can do right here that's pretty cool. So equip your hawk ring. Alright. And then your bow. And if you can aim it just right, you can actually kill Mantis right here. But you have to... You can't do it with aiming. You have to do it with just kind of aiming down there. See what I mean? So you can sit right here and just range him until he dies. It does take a while to do this. But I just wanted to show you what it looks like though, because you can do it still. But yeah, if you want to sit there and range Manus, you can do that. And he will die that way. But we're going to fight him, because I want to show you Sif. So we need to get some more Estus though before we fight him. We're gonna go talk to the mushroom again, Elizabeth.
Thank goodness thou art what is thy will. Not long ago, I had another visitor, a human like thine self, from a faraway time. Only he was dreadfully odious, and I'm afraid that he is still amongst us. He wore a hat and a long black coat. I am.
All right, she was talking about Marvel's Chester. Alright, this boss fight is with a enemy named Manus. He is just, I really don't even know of a good strategy to fight him other than that cheese I showed you just now with the arrow. You can sit there and range him constantly until he dies and you won't take any damage. But the other way that I know to beat him is just to put your Havel's gear on and fight him that way. And you can survive if you fight him that way if you're high enough level. So that's what we're going to do. We're just going to put our Havel's gear on and go about it that way. We're going to try to summon Sif if I can get over to him. He's kind of hard to see in the battle arena, so we're going to try to find him. Yeah, so Manus is just a... He's very tough, so... It might take me a couple times to put him down, but I'll get him down. He does start using one of those big darkness moves. Shoots a lot of those dark orbs out at once after he gets health down a little bit more. So maybe we can get Sif summoned like really fast this time around. Last time was just a disaster. I couldn't find him, so I ended up wasting a whole bunch of S's trying to find him. Oh yeah, I don't even know why I'm not able to find Sif anyway, so I'm not in human form. That explains a lot. Manus is just incredibly strong, very, very strong. Probably one of the hardest bosses in the game, in my opinion. If you sit there and kind of fight him like with a strategy, it's just, I don't know, it's very difficult to fight him. I've always always had a problem with him. I guess we'll get good at figuring out how to get Sif up and where he is and stuff. Ooh, the Silk Catalyst. Wow, that's a tough drop right there. Every day, Ulysil's sorcery catalyst, formed by several enchanted branches. Boost sorcery adjustment, but lost land sorceries are not offensive, and attacks are not boosted by intelligence. Thank you, Mr. Sif. Thanks for your help, buddy. Alright. Got rid of Manus. Good job, guys. Good job. I'm gonna go talk to Dusk. We have saved Dusk. Get our bonfire here. We're going to warp to Ulysil Township and go ahead and take care of Chester. Here it is. Oh yeah, let's do the reinforced weapon real quick. Divine Claymore. This will get your, that should already get your, Divine Weapon trophy right there. And we also need to read Soul of Manus. Soul of Manus, Father of the Abyss. This extraordinary soul is a viscous, lukewarm lump of gentle humanity. Ancient Manus was clearly once human, but he became the Father of the Abyss after his humanity went wild, eternally seeking his precious broken pendant. But we found his broken pendant. Haha. So, alright. Chester, obviously, we don't really need to buy anything off of him. We'll look and see, but everything he sells is, like, really expensive anyway, so he just, we need to get rid of him.
Oh, you have quite some nerve, or are you just thick? Fine, then.
We'll see if there's anything he has that we don't have already. No, we have everything he offers, so yeah, we're good.
I'll be seeing you. If you survive your travels. What now? You think this is all my fault? How very, very petty of you. You win. Oh.
Well, where is it? There we go. Stickering top hat. Black top hat worn by Marvelous Chester, man of mystery, lost in the past. Aware of this top hat cracks a dubious, permanent grin, the curse of Chester. Alright, and now we need to go and speak with, or open Hawkeye Goff's door and talk to him, because we have the key. Hawkeye Goff.
A visitor, have we? Thou must be the one who freed Artorias. An old friend he was. Thanks to thee, he left this world with honor intact. And here I am, retired and blind. Of little help to thee, I'm afraid.
Let's see what he's got to buy here. So we'll buy his other two carvings that we haven't gotten yet. And Goff's great arrows. We're going to actually be picking some of these up in a little bit, so we don't need to buy these.
If I seek to explore this domain, be wary of a black dragon. I fear thee no match for this terrible beast. There's very little to be said. How good is a dog? No bears to hunt. But I'm lucky to be alive, I suppose. There's very little could it, but I'm lucky. Farewell. Be thy life as thou seest.
Alright, so, now what we gotta do is go down and go check out Calamite real quick. In Calamite's lair, there's a... I think the final two crystal lizards, might be two or one, but I know there's at least one in the game, so we'll take that out. And then once you get to Calamite's lair, just touch the ground and then warp back and come talk to Hawkeye Golf again, and something really cool happens. Be wary of these dogs down here. These guys inflict bleed on you. So there's an item back here in the back. But there's some dogs guarding it. There's one dog guarding it. No, there's two. Here's Calamite's lair right here. Crystal Lizard is going to be down this waterfall. You can fall on top of it and do a punch attack like that to kill him. Once the boss fight starts, just warp out. Actually, wait a minute. You can just warp out now. You won't start the boss fight yet, so... All you have to do is hit the bottom. Maybe you just have to get him to show up, and then that's it. But go back up here and talk to Hawkeye Goff. Probably one of the coolest cutscenes in the game. Watch this. Keep in mind, this dude is blind, alright?
for a good spell, the rest is in thine hands. I await good tidings. Dragon slain. Knighthood's highest calling. An ancient dragon. Strive with her now. He will not be put down easily. Dragons shall never be forgotten. We knights fought valiantly, but for every one of them, we lost 70 of our own. Exhilaration, pride, hatred, rage. Dragons teased out our dearest emotions. I will understand one day. At our twilight, old thoughts return in great waves of nostalgia. But I suspect that has taken a gander at him. But the dark of the abyss, which swallowed poor Artorias, threatens to devour our entire land of Ulysseal. It seems that this dire fate is unavoidable, but seduced by a dark serpent or no, they awoke that thing themselves and drove it mad. One's demise is always one's own making. Mistake my words. I cherish my word. Woodcarving is a nuanced art. I would have much to talk about with that blacksmith. In truth, how is the old chap, I wonder? Still hammering away, I should hope.
Alright, that exhausts his dialogue there, and go down and try to fight Calamite. Now, Calamite is not a particularly difficult fight, however, it is very difficult to cut his tail. And we need to cut his tail to get his drop. This is a final tail cut in the game. There's a particular move you need to bait to get him to fly at you. And once he flies at you, you dodge out of the way, and then you dodge out of the way again, and he tries to hit you with his tail. And that's when you cut it. That may take a little bit of practice to get it down, but you can do it. It took me a while to finally learn everything that you did in order to get the tail cut, but you can do it. So. As you see, now the boss fog is up. Now his, life bar will not appear until you actually touch the ground on the bottom here. So, just so you're aware. Now we're gonna try to get this tail cut quickly, hopefully. If we get it quickly, we'll be able to fight him, kill him, and that'll be that, so.
Oh,
That's the move you want right there. You have one hit on it, maybe take two. You can get it around him right there. You can also try to cut his tail, but it is really hard. I'm gonna stay away from that. The issue with that is double damage for a while. Tail cut is really tough, man, so just keep at it though, you'll get it. It's really not that bad, as long as you, once you get a tail cut, you can just sit there and take him out. Because he has lots of openings, as you saw. I mean, I was sitting there dodging him forever without him really doing a lot to me, so. Hopefully we'll get it this time, guys. I surely hope so. I'm trying to bait that attack so I can be able to slam his tail down, but it's a little harder than it looks. somehow managed to get behind him when he does that. Stands up and freezes his fire. I think we're gonna come back to Calamite. The video's getting kinda long, so we'll fight Calamite next video. And we'll go get our body here and go finish up Quelana's source or pyromancies. And we'll check on Rhea and see if she's still chilling in the undead parish. But this guy is really giving me some problems today, I'm telling you. I don't know what it is. Usually I can cut the tail pretty quick, but I don't know why he's being this way. I think this ought to be enough to get us all the pyromancies. Calamite is probably one of the hardest tail cuts in the game. Just probably the hardest one. Because he has so many attacks, and that one where he flies at you, you have to time it just right for him to slam his tail down and then get one hit on it. And I think two hits is enough to cut his tail, but man, it is really tough to get those hits. Without dying, obviously, but just waiting it out. I mean, I could have killed him probably already, no problem. But trying to wait for those tail slams, they just don't come. You just can't get it. So I don't know. Maybe we'll have some better luck tomorrow. But I want to spend more time. I want to go look it up and see how some other people do it. If there's another way to do it, but I'm pretty sure the only way to do it is to wait for them to slam that tail down by dodging his where he flies at you.
expecting you.
Okay, great fireball. Firestorm. Fire whip. Undead rapport. Great combustion.
I am blessed to have met you. I suppose I can call you fool no longer. Thank you. I suppose... Ah, very well. There is nothing left for me to teach you. Our time together is done. It was short, but sweet. Fool, hurry along. I can do nothing more for you.
Okay, so we got some spells there. Great Fireball. Ultimate Fireball Pyromancy. Hurl Giant Fireball. Solomon, the Master Pyromancer, also called the Great Fireball after this spell. Believe Pyromancy was rooted in an adoration of fire. Those who acquire the spell usually agree. And we got the Great Chaos Fireball, Art of the Flame of Chaos, which engulfed the Witch of Izalith and her daughters. Hurl a giant Chaos Fireball. The Flame of Chaos can melt stone, producing a short-lived lava glob. I think I already read this one. It's the Flame of Tempest. Greater Combustion, there we go. Great Combustion creates a powerful flame, but many sorcerers mock the simplicity of this spell. I think we have Fire Tempest. Primal Pyromancy of Koilana of the Izalith erects giant fire pillars in the vicinity. No, this one we did already. Maybe it was Chaos Storm. I can't remember which spells we got. About that. I know we got this one. Advanced Pyromancy of Koilana of Izalith. Charm undead and gain temporary allies. The living are lured by flame, and this relationship is part and parcel to the art of pyromancy. Can be used by either gender. That should have got you your pyromancy, master of pyromancy trophy right there. And then if we go back to Quelana, she'll be gone. She won't be there anymore. She's still there.
I am almost ready.
Okay, I don't think she's gonna leave.
And be safe.
So, we'll go ahead and take her out. Being for casting miracles of the gods, ivory talismans are granted only to female clerics, and their value is affected dramatically by their owner's faith. So we got our ivory talisman there. I think that's going to wrap us up for today. Next video, we'll take on Calamite and try to get his tail cut. We will get his tail cut eventually. But Yeah, that's what we'll do. So Calamite will be it tomorrow for next video, and if we have time, we'll do some other stuff, but we just didn't have time today and running along with videos. So anyways, thanks for watching, thanks for subscribing, leave a comment if you want, and see you in the next video. Peace.